welcome to Loch Lomond. I have arrived yesterday, paddled from all the way there. The weather was terrible, the wind and the waves. That's not the place I wanted originally to be, but I had to escape the bad weather, and hopefully this morning I will be able to hit the next island. Unfortunately, another rookie mistake, my memory card crashed filming on the way here, so I don't have the footage how I got here, so video probably gonna start here on one of these islands. I tried to walk through it. It's not a very good island. I don't like it. I need to move on. Originally I have to be behind this island, but the wind and waves, they just brought me here. It was a very hard battle, so I decided I'll stop here for a night and see how it is in the morning. And the morning is beautiful, so I'm gonna move on to the next island, something that's a little bit more fishable and livable. Yeah, and my memory card have crashed. The memory card, my existing memory card have crashed on the way here, so there's no footage of how I actually got on this island. The video is probably gonna start from here, so another rookie mistake. Always format your cards before going. I also forgot the keels for my boat, so that's a challenge. It keeps turning on me all the time, so, but hey ho, still have to do it. Hello. So I have come to this new spot, which is a different island. This is where I'm gonna pick up. I already seen some nice mushrooms. There's a deep hole there, so hopefully I can catch some fish and yeah, take it from there. If no good, I'll move on tomorrow again. But look at this. Look at the views. Looks like it's gonna start raining. Already did drip a couple of times. That's where my camp is gonna be. Already had a quick walk around the forest, around the island. Loads of different mushrooms. Loads of them. Some of them are so old that they just fallen apart. A lot of them slugs have eaten. I'm gonna see if I can get a few to add, a few penny buns maybe, to add to my dinner today, this evening. Let's have a quick walk. I'll just take you around, see what I could find.
Thank you.
what I mean about the old mushrooms. Just have a look at this. All these were huge penny buns, still standing, but it's well eaten. It's quite soft as well, so the middle will be eaten by bugs. Oh, another one there. All rotten. Too wet. And of course the puffer mushroom. Started to rain now. First time since I've been here. It started to rain, and it will be raining all day, probably all night, and there's a wind warning tomorrow. So yeah, it's turning into a survival now. Just about managed to start the fire. Hopefully this will be enough to cook some food, because I didn't bring any gas with me, so fire is all I have. Finally died off a little bit. Still raining, but not very heavy. Last 12 hours I spent inside the tent, hiding from a heavy rain. Really, really heavy. Just had a chance to come out and stretch out a little bit without getting too wet. But yeah, it should stop completely for about 4 hours. And that's the time I'm gonna use to try to start the fire. Dry the rest, dry my clothes, and prepare for tomorrow. Yellow warning of wind was issued for tomorrow, so I need to prepare a little bit. There's no big branches overhanging my tent, so nothing can really fall on me. That's about it. I'm gonna find some big stones to prep the corners, to prep all the pegs on my tent to give it extra support for the high winds. That held up quite well to the big rain, to be fair. It's only a cheap tent. The porch got wet a little bit, but that's about it. It's a cheap 35 quid tent. Battling the heavy rain. Loch Lomond. Tomorrow is a no-go for me because of the yellow wind warnings. So it's gotta be Thursday. There's gonna be a window with a really slightly rain. And that's what I'm gonna use to heat the shore. Because after that, it's gonna be even worse. Hopefully I'll find a way to start a fire today. Somehow. So I can cook some food. Dry my clothes. Yeah. Might even have some time left to try to catch some fish. I'm not expecting to catch any trout. I think it's out of season. But I might get a little pike or something. Nothing special, but still nice. Something to kill time with. So somehow I have managed to get the fire going. So I will have some food, yay! That was a challenge. It took me nearly 2 hours before it was burning on its own. Very difficult in the rain. So calm. Will be storm tomorrow. So this is it. I have managed to have some food. Luckily, the weather is absolutely calm. Just felt some drips, so it is gonna start raining later on, and it's not gonna stop until tomorrow evening. So what I have done, I have cooked all of my food. So if I need to, I can just eat it tomorrow cold without having to worry with starting a fire. I also have a little stove to make a cup of tea or something, so I should be alright. So I got 2 more nights left. and then I'll be heading towards home in that direction. Yeah, I am getting tired. All the food is cooking. Yeah, tomorrow should be tomorrow was a wind warning as well, yellow wind warnings. So I have propped my tent as much as I could. Yeah, hopefully it'll stay on. So yeah, let's have my final cup of coffee and then go put my head down, because I am tired and my back is hurting and everything. So yeah, enjoying the last bit of good weather, because it's gonna pour it down all day tomorrow and all night. Yeah, so I'm gonna burn all this wood. I won't need it tomorrow. I won't be starting fire tomorrow. Not when it's not the struggles I had today trying to start it. I ain't doing it again. All right, catch you later, guys. Another night survived. Didn't get wet, it was raining, absolutely pouring all night. Didn't see any strong wind yet, but the water is creeping up. More rain and I'll be underwater. I hope not. Quite a bit of waves. Which gonna make me struggle to get back. And the headwind. So, one more night. Hopefully I can get back tomorrow. If not, I'll stay on for another night. Look at this. It's beautiful. It's a bit chilly. Everything is wet. I'm not gonna bother with the fire today. Just hang by. Eat the rest of my food. And go home tomorrow. A little bit lighter with no food. Some friends coming to visit me. Rain has just gone and it's gone quiet again, very quiet, and the water just keeps creeping up. That's how much further it's gone now. I've moved my tent a little bit. It was over here in this dike, in this little little dim, so I moved it because I do expect a lot more rain tonight and all day tomorrow, so I don't want to wake up in the water. But yeah, tomorrow I'll be hitting the I'll be heading back to the shore tomorrow. That's 4 days I've been here. It's gonna be my fourth night tonight. Maybe gonna do another night on the shore before heading to the Lake District. Whew. So nice when it's not raining. Got a ducky here. Hi, little ducky. A new discovery for me. I was just sat down on a chair and I heard some noise behind me. I turn around, there was a bunch of ducks picking acorns off the floor. Now I never knew that ducks like acorns. Try to demonstrate it. There you go, ducks.
go. Acorn. Gone. Oh, you can't reach it. Come here. So I got another peaceful hour with no rain, with the chance to observe a little bit where I am and what I'm doing and stuff like that. The water is really creeping up on me. I put a stick in there just to see how fast and where it is. Yeah, I don't know how big of a window I'm gonna have tomorrow morning. But I don't want to risk and waste any time, so I've packed the majority of my stuff away already. All I have to do is tent and my sleeping gear. Put it under my kayak there. So yeah. So quick check for ticks. And probably gonna try to put my head down, because tomorrow looks like 7 o'clock in the morning. Is a good chance to start packing, because it should be quiet until like 11 o'clock, so that's plenty of time for me to get back all the way to the car, even if I have a headwind, which I hope I don't. All right guys, see you tomorrow. Have a good night. Today I'm gonna try to get back to the shore, and the weather is terrible. It's very wavy. It's gonna be a big challenge for me to get back to the shore. However, I need to set off before this water creeps up on me. That's the stick I left out yesterday, and it's underwater. So anyway, somehow I need to get off here soon. My 35 pound tent held up quite well. Through this weather, wind and rain. Right, time to leave this place. Okay, let's start packing. Hopefully, hit the shore. Ooh, looks horrible. Ooh. So I'm all ready to go. Boat is loaded. As you can see, it's quite wavy. And it will be even more wavy as we hit over there in the open water. And it's just about, and it started raining. Beautiful. So it's gonna be a hell of a trip back. Well, thank you very much. A lovely camping place. Hopefully come back here. Quite too many ticks, but yeah, absolutely adored it. Last observation of where I actually was. Let's see if I can survive the way back home. Yeah. That's how wavy it is. Yeah. So that's it. I'm ready to go. Hopefully I'll make it to the other side without any problems. However, I've set up the GoPro on the front of my kayak. I don't think I'll have a chance to play around with it, so I'm just gonna film all the way from here. Try to film all the struggles, if there will be any. I hope not, but I'll see you on the other side. Okay, let's go. And it just started raining. Ooh.
going against wind. Waves picking up as well. It's a big job without heels. The boat keeps spinning. That's why I didn't go out on it much. Because it's a hard job. Another. That's a very rookie mistake. Leaving parts of your boat at home. Well, that didn't stop me traveling to the island and spending a few nights there in a bad conditions. Never done that before, but I think everyone should try to experience it at some point. And that was my time. Cheap gear. Very little experience, and on my own. I don't really recommend that, but where I come from, I haven't got many people who are willing to go out. Ah, piss off wind. I can't keep the boat straight, for fuck's sake. If I'm on the island or not, but definitely having a rest. Whew. Okay, let's carry on. Let's carry on into this paradise, windy, rainy paradise. Very shallow in here. You can see the bottom. Oh, back. Sun is coming up. So nice. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. What a great workout. How beautiful is here? Oh my god, absolutely amazing. Difficulties don't mean nothing when you have these things around you.
is it, folks. I'm back to the spot where I set it off 4 nights ago. And I headed off that way. That's where the islands are. Spent 4 nights on the islands. On 2 of the islands, actually. I'm not sure what they're called, like, but a lot of hours spent in the tent because of the rain. But hey ho, Scotland, I'm guessing it's raining here all the time, so I did expect that. And when it was stopping raining, every time it would stop rain, I'd come out and enjoy, observe the view. This is what it's all about. I tried a bit of fishing, caught a little pike and a few perch. Nothing special, but was still good to kill some time. This is it, I'm guessing. My Loch Lomond adventure is coming to the end. I've made it back safely, even though coming back today was a big challenge. Headwind, big rain. But hey ho, I've made it. And I'm happy that I did it. I'm very happy that I did it. Just gonna sit here and observe this view for a few more minutes before I set off. Absolutely extraordinary. Ben Lomond over there.